and have a celebration. A celebration. The music up, the windows down. Yeah, we'll be doing what we do, just pretending that we're cool, and we know it too. Okay, it's 12 o'clock on the 31st of August 2018, and I've arrived in Anglesey, Holyhead. I've registered, I've had a jack of potato, and I'm ready. It's a 3-day race. This first day is just over 35 miles, so I've not recce'd this first day at all. I've recce'd from Penman Point onwards, which is about a third of the way into tomorrow. But this first section is supposed to be the best, really, in the sense of the coastal path. So looking forward to it. You can see the scene behind me, people registering, just sitting around. There's two races today. There's the Fire Lighter as well, which is just this first day, the 35 and a bit miles. So I think there'll be about 50 or so doing that, and a 50 odd doing our race. So probably over 100 or so doing it together. So looking forward to it, and I'll try and do some updates around the course. Island, come over the bridge, past the first checkpoint, and we're in sort of a good runnable bit now. Good start, nice even pace, the weather's great, a little bit warm if anything, but that's fine, a little bit of wind, a bit cool, but very happy with my start. An update. Got the sea on my left. Been going for 3 hours 18, 17, just over 17 miles. Just been through the second checkpoint, grabbed some coke and a bounty bar and refilled my tailwind. I must admit I'm finding it pretty warm today, which is, I always struggle a bit in the heat. So I can definitely feel the pace. Still moving okay, but I must admit it would be quite nice to get into the, it's a bit cooler. But look at this, absolutely beautiful. Okay, just an update. Been going for almost 6.5 hours, 28, almost 29 miles. So I've got about 5 miles to go, and we're just climbing up now to the first Honesty Book, which is just around the corner. Running with a guy called Gordon from Wales who did the Southern Upland Way, so we've just been chatting away. Only finished over a week ago and he's doing this one, so it's been good to be with him for the last few miles. And it's a lot cooler now, so feeling a bit better. It was really hot a few hours ago. Hoping to do it around about 7:15, maybe 7:30, but I did find the heat. Most people did. It was really hot, and that slowed me down a bit. So I just wanted to keep going. Once it got cooler, around about 4:30, 5:00, the last 3 hours were a lot more comfortable. So that was a lot better and more enjoyable. So had a nice hot shower. I've had a lasagna, and it's about 10:30 now, 10:40. So. Just about to head to sleep, hopefully get some sleep. There's still runners to come in. I'll just give you a little look around the leisure centre in a minute. And I'm sleeping next to Mark and Helen. Say hi, guys.
Hi.
So they had a really good day. Big day tomorrow. So we start at 6 and we've got 65 miles to do. So, but the weather forecast, I think, is for a lot. There's a bit of a cloud base, so it's not going to be anywhere near as hot. And maybe a little bit of drizzle as well, which will probably be quite welcome. So I've the first maybe 20 miles I've not done, but once we get to Pemben Point, then I've recce'd that last year, so I've got a bit more idea of what's to come then. So hopefully I'll get a decent sleep, and then I'll carry on in the morning. So here's the leisure centre. Everybody's found a space around the outside of the hall. And there's a massage up there. It's now 6:15 on Saturday, the 1st of September, and had a sleep last night, if you can call it that. It's in a big sports hall, and the lights were on the whole time. So I dozed, but you're resting, so that's fine. So I was up about 4:45, had some breakfast, and got myself sorted out. And the race briefing's about to be in the next couple of minutes, and then we'll start off at 6. And the forecast is definitely for cooler today, and there's a lot of cloud about, so I must have been quite grateful it's not going to be as hot as it was yesterday. But this is the long day, 65 miles, so it's going to be a long day, so we'll see how it goes. Looking forward to it.
Okay, sun rising over the sea, been going just over 2 miles, and legs feel good, and we're after about a mile or so, we're back on the path after being in the leisure centre. But look at that for the morning view.
Progress report. Been going for 2 hours, 20 minutes. Not quite sure the distance, because I was trying to get my route on, and I pressed the stop button rather than the button to get the options. So I had to start again. So I'm not quite sure the distance. I think there's about 2 miles to go to the next check, the first checkpoint, and that's 11.8 miles. So I think I'm around about probably just about 10 miles, I think. So I'll get an idea once I get to that checkpoint how much it was. Anyway, beautiful morning. Been running with various people, and feel good actually. Legs feel strong. Just trying to pace it well so that when I am running, I'm just taking it nice and steady, and trying to enjoy the day. It's a long day, and I just want to make sure I can keep moving. And, okay, just an update. Been going for 4.5 hours, just on 18 miles, and been running with Melissa at the front there and Chris. They're Melissa from New Zealand, and then this guy's just joined us as well. So. The next checkpoint is probably less than 1/2 mile away, Red Wharf Bay, and then we've got a longer one then, about 10 miles to Pemben Point. And during that leg, that's where the recce runner did, so
in about sort of 7-8 miles time, I'll be on the part that I've done before. Okay, so here we are at Penman Point Checkpoint. Thank you very much, guys. How's it going so far?
Oh, brilliant.
You enjoying yourselves?
Amazing!
Yeah. Thank you very much for all your help.
You're welcome.
It's a nice spot as well. Look at this. Penman Point, and there's the lighthouse. Right, so we've got about 5 and a bit miles to Beaumaris, which is the halfway point, where we get our drop bag. Ian's sorting his feet out. Feeling okay, Ian?
Magic. Never been better.
Mr. Positive, that's what we want. Okay, here we are at the Beaumaris checkpoint. So Beaumaris is just that way. We just ran down past the pier. And then this is basically the halfway point. Thank you very much to the checkpoint team. Give us a wave. Thank you very much. Thanks, guys. Thanks for all your help.
See you later.
Are you going now, John?
Got a bit of a climb up the hill now.
Any little one.
Okay, so here we are at the Sisu checkpoint. How's it going so far, guys?
Really good, thank you. Yeah.
Smile for the camera, please, team. Thank you very much. Well done. You've got a great job up there. Enjoying it? Yeah. Well done. Thank you very much.
Are you enjoying it?
It would jinx me if I wore it. Don't you ever stop? I'm here with you. Now it's all or nothing, 'cause you said you follow through. You follow me.
Okay, it's now Sunday morning. It's about 10 to 6, so the race starts in about 10 minutes time. Didn't do so much video last night. I got in about 20 to 12, and by the time I'd sort of got myself, there's no showers here, so I had to give a good wash with wet wipes, and then had a massage actually, and then probably tried to get to sleep about 1, so slept on and off till about 4:30 and got up. Good news is my legs feel good. One or two little hot spots on my feet, but nothing that won't, you know, they'll ease off as I get running. And so looking forward to the final day. This one's just under 34 miles, so looking forward to this. I've wrecked this route last May, so it's good. And the good news is, just heard from Emma and Jonas that they've had their little boy, Jacob. So that's great news, and hopefully by the time I finish, there'll be some photos as well. So I'm a granddad for the 6th time, so that's an exciting start to the day. Okay, so I might do one or two. I didn't do as much yesterday. I was working hard to run with Chris and Melissa, and so I thought if I'd stop too often, I'd lose touch with them. So I didn't do a great deal of video yesterday. But really enjoyed it. I felt strong all day, actually. I finished really well. I was with them until Zoo, and then I pushed on over the last sort of 18 miles and finished over an hour ahead of them. So that was encouraging. And I felt pretty good. Right, that's the 5-minute briefing. So need to go and get ready to run. The first checkpoint of the day at Ross McGare, Sandy's Bar and Bistro. One of the guys, I think Bill, Ben, maybe, who organises the race. His dad and my dad run this. So it is. Well, you're
Cheers.
Yeah, you're superb.
Pleasure. Thank you.
Excellent, thank you very much.
Cheers. Absolutely.
Melissa going all right?
I think so, yeah, it's not too far behind.
They've gone a little bit.
So this is the checkpoint at 4 Mile Bridge. So we've done just on 14 miles.
They've just kind of...
How's the checkpoint going?
Beautiful.
Everybody happy?
Drink or anything?
Thank you very much, guys. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. So here we are at the final checkpoint. How's it going, guys?
All great. Yay.
We're running it.
Soup's brilliant.
Thank you so much for all your help.
Well done. Thank you. For the
so these are the power behind the throne, is it? Well done. So you reckon that we're about 20th, 19th, 20th?
What's that?
We're position-wise, about 19 or 20?
Yeah, halfway down the pack, so okay. 19 or 20. Yeah.
And we've got just over 9 miles to go, haven't we?
Yeah, don't trip on the last 9 miles.
Yeah, all right.
Two more books to get as well.
Oh,
so thank you very much, everybody. Well, that's me finished the Ring of Fire. My overall time was 34 hours, 33 minutes and 4 seconds, I think. So pretty pleased with that. I was 8 hours 34 today, and again, felt pretty strong most of the day. The last half an hour, I was getting tired. I just wanted to finish, but that was great. I ran with Helen for a bit, and then Cottage for Triada Bay, and then she just finished a few minutes ahead of me, so we had a little chat as well. So great event, really, really enjoyed it, and just got a small matter of driving home now. I think I might actually stay in Wrexham tonight and then go tomorrow, because I'm not sure if I could face an 8-6 hour drive. Anyway, it was a great event and really enjoyed it, and I hope you've enjoyed this some of the video clips that I took of this event.